Well, good day, YouTube, and welcome to another episode of the Albino Runner Beer Review. No, this isn't really it. This is the hashtag FABQ, the Frequently Asked Beer Questions. This was started by Tasting Niche, the queen of the jump cut, the meister of the jump cut, the supreme lord of the jump cut. You know I love you, Niche. Anyway, I was tagged by Rod from Rod J. Beer Ventures, and then I was tagged by Matt of Massive Beer Reviews, both good guys, and I meant to get this done earlier, but being me, it takes a little bit of time to do things. I have this cell phone on. I'm recording on my one cell phone. I have my extra here for the questions. I'm gonna just zoom in a little bit here. We're just gonna talk. Open up a beer here. Lake Wilcox Mad Quacker. Nice little amber ale. We're gonna drink it right from the can because we're classy like that. And let's get into this. How did I get into beer and why beer? I don't know, because it was what I got into. It was cheaper than buying a bottle of whiskey. It tasted better than drinking a bottle of whiskey. In all honesty, when I really started drinking in high school, I wasn't even really drinking beer at the time. I was drinking UFOs, which were unflavored objects. They were a 1 liter bottle. They were $7 at the time. They basically tasted like, Seven Up. And, Wildberry coolers, 8% alcohol, Wildberry vodka drinks, 1 liter bottles, $8, taste just like Kool-Aid, Smirnoff Ice, all that type of stuff. And I remember I would always get told by my buddies, "You're a pussy for drinking that." And I would look at them and I go, "Really? Because mine's 8% alcohol, and yours is 5. So which one of the two of us is the pussy?" Remember, I'm older, right? So that's the way it was talked about back then. I had drank beer before. I drank lots of beer before, but the taste of beer, the taste that was beer at the time, your regular adjunct lagers, just wasn't what I liked. I didn't care for that taste. So it turned me off. I didn't care to drink it. So it wasn't until, I was like 22 that I really got into beer. I drank beer off and on since I was 6. We'll go into that later on. But it wasn't until later in my life that I really got into it. And it really started because I went to the LCBO one day. And I only had like $10. And I went into the beer area. And there was a bunch of different beers. And they were like $2 each. And I picked up 5 of them, went home and tried them. And some of them I liked and some of them I didn't. And that really started me off. And then the Ultra Lounge opened up at my work. And they were training people in things. They took us to Molson Beer School, and Molson Beer School taught me that there was much more to... It's funny that it was Molson Beer School that taught me how much more there was in the ideals of beer than anything. It wasn't the craft brewery, because, yeah, like 13, 14 years ago, there were craft breweries in Ontario, but not many, and they weren't big. They weren't really known. So it was really Molson that got me into experimenting more than anything else. What's my favorite beer? Always a question that that is truthfully a frequently asked question. What's your favorite beer? What's your favorite beer? I could give the cliched answer of whatever I'm drinking at this moment, but that's not true. I mean, there's beers that I drink, and I don't even want to finish them. So it's not like whatever beer I'm drinking is my favorite beer at the moment. Beers I love, if we're going just by pure on taste, I don't know, Bellwood's Bring Out Your Dead, the Cognac Barrel Aged Imperial Stout. Fucking amazing beer. But there's so many other things out there too that are amazing. I don't know if I would say that that's my favorite beer. It's a beer I love. 10 out of 10 beers. What beers have I given 10 out of 10s on? Half Hours on Earth's Totally. I love that beer. Four wins, Nectarius. Flying Monkeys, fucking Orange Mungus. Like, those are probably my favorite beers. They taste amazing. Do they taste like beer per se? Possibly not, mattering who you're talking to. But I love them. So, yeah. So those three would probably be my favorite beer. Next question. Question three. If you could have one beer, what would it be? If I could have one beer for the rest of my life, what would it be? I'm going to guess this would be like a desert island beer, or it's the only beer left in existence type of thing. So that's not necessarily your favorite beer. That's more what you could drink every day, all day. And I mean, in all honesty, I guess I could still say Flying Monkeys, Orange Mungus, or Half Hour on Earth, totally, because neither of them are overpowering. But in all honesty, if I was going to go local, like something from around here, probably a Lock Street Starboard Stout. If I was going to go something from anywhere in Ontario, probably, I don't know, what beer could I drink all the time? Black Oak's Nut Brown. It's a good Nut Brown. But then, really, if I was going to answer this question truthfully, I would probably say Stiegl Radler. If I could drink one beer, and one beer only forever, it would probably be that. It's 2.4% alcohol. I could drink it all day, every day. It does have some vitamins in it. It has some nice juice content in it. Has a good flavor. It's available almost everywhere. It's not that expensive. It would probably be my one. And if I was going to go with like a macro-ish, like more so just your average standard lager, or cream ale, or export ale, or anything like that, I don't know. Miller Lite has no flavor. Four. How can I drink so much and stay healthy? Who says you drink a lot, though? That's the thing, right? This is the thing that people don't get. And I think it's... I'm sure a lot of people have said the same thing. When you're looking at these reviews, it looks like there's a lot. I mean, I have thousands of videos up there. I normally drink twice a week. One, when we do our BDU hangout on YouTube. And the other time when I'm reviewing. I might have three or four beers each time. I might end up reviewing, if there's somebody with me, those three or four beers might get spread out into 12 beers. It's still three or four beers when you take how much I've ingested, but I've tried 12 different beers that night. It adds up quickly, but it's not like you're actually ingesting all that much. How do I stay healthy? I don't really think I'm all that healthy at the moment. I have been healthy in the past. I mean, I was a Canadian Championship wrestler. I was a rugby player. I was a football player. I did the Highland Games. I did the Strongman. I did all that. Then I got married and had kids. I have three children. I run a beer festival. I run social media for the beer festival and for the beer review. I do the beer review. I do the beer festival. I do my kids. I spend time with my kids. I spend time with my wife. I work a 44 hour a week job, which isn't that much, but the hours it is makes it worse. So I don't really stay as healthy as I would like to. I am trying to get back in shape. First and foremost was my diet, more so than my alcohol intake. I've changed my diet a little bit. I have to change it a little bit more. But, you know, the first step, the easy things to get rid of, don't drink pop anymore. You know, that type of stuff. Then, no more cheesecake at the middle of the night, even if my wife goes out and buys herself one. If you want to stay a giant woman, you stay a giant woman. I'm not eating that anymore. Stuff like that. So, just choices that you make. Again, I think a lot of people see the belly around people and think that it's all from the beer, but if you really were to go into it, it would most likely the diet of the person has a lot more to do with it than the beer itself. And that's just the way it is. Your diet and your exercise level matter a lot. It is what it is. I have about 5 years before all three of my kids are in school, and I can wake up and start working out instead of waking up 2.5 hours after I get home from work and being up with a kid all day. I can wake up 8 hours after getting home from work, being filled with energy, working out, and then going and getting all three of my kids from school. So I can't, as much as I love spending time with my kids right now, I can't wait till I can actually sleep and start working out again and trying to get back in the shape I was in when I did strongman and all that. Next question. Am I an Alky? See, Niche said that this were frequently asked beer questions. I see it every once in a while. I'll see a comment like that in the comments on videos. Are you an alcoholic? You must be an alcoholic. Look at these alcoholics. Most of the time it's trolls out there, and it's random. Like, maybe you'll get one or two a year. If that's a question you're being frequently asked, first off, maybe you should look at your friends. Maybe you have dicks for friends. And second, maybe you should look at yourself, because maybe you are doing something that would make people think you're an Alky. More so than just posting a weekly video, or because Niche doesn't post as many as I do. If I post 25 videos a week and I get one a year, are you an Alky? Maybe there's something going on there. Also, I don't think, maybe it's a European versus Canadian thing, but not many people seem to come up to you and go, hey, are you an Alky? No, it doesn't happen. I mean, I'm seen at beer festivals, I'm seen at breweries, I'm seen online. Nobody has ever asked me in person if I'm an Alky. And like I said, a few people online every once in a while. So I don't think that's a frequently asked question. Am I an alcoholic? No. I can go weeks, I can go months without drinking. I've done it in the past, I can do it again. It doesn't matter. I enjoy drinking, yes, which some people can say is the signs of being an alcoholic as well. But do I need to drink? No, I don't need to. And I don't feel the urge to. It's not like I'm at work and I'm like, oh my god, I gotta get home and have a beer. Or I'm out somewhere and I'm like, can I get a beer? Half the time when I go out with my family to a restaurant or something, I'm just drinking water. I don't buy beer at restaurants often. I don't buy it at bars often. But I am drinking alone right now, which is apparently another sign for it too. So, I mean, it all matters what you feel. For me, I feel an alcoholic is somebody that needs alcohol to function. I don't need alcohol to function. You know what I need to function? Sleep and sex. That's right, I said it. I'm addicted to sex, guys. Plus, the mental illnesses I do have, if you guys have watched Heart to Heart with the Rhinos, most of those aren't usually compiled with addiction. They're usually compiled with other types of things. So, yeah, it is what it is. What's question six here? Do I brew? Not as often as I'd like. I have three kids. I have a job. I have a beer festival. I have this. Do I brew? I brew. Lee's tried a lot of my beers. Nick from Maxwell Stars tried a lot of my beers. Paul from PA Brew News has had some. I've pulled them out at beer festivals when the guys were here. I've brewed commercially. I've done collabs commercially. So yeah, I do brew. When I brew at home, I mostly do brew in a bag. So you do your mash in the bag, or extract kits that I edit with new adjuncts and new and different hop oils and different, even some other malts that I'll throw in. But I do those for time constraint reasons more than anything else. And when you're at a brewery, you're doing all malt in the fucking mash tun and everything else. But yeah, a lot of times I will do brew in a bag, or I will do fucking extract kits. And to anyone that goes, oh my god, you draw around an extract kit? Extract kits, you can do beer that is just as good as all malt. And a lot of times people can't tell it's an extract kit if you don't leave it as just an extract kit. Like, if you just take a extract stout and dump it in and just brew that, yeah, people might be able to tell it's a stout. Well, an extract kit. But if you take that extract kit and you add your own hops to it, you add, I don't know, some coffee to it, some oatmeal, this or that, people aren't really going to be able to tell. And how do I know that? Because I've won an award in an all malt category with an extract kit. It's not hard to do. You can get good beer with it, and it's a lot less time consuming. What is my favorite ingredient? So I'm gonna assume this isn't looking at adjuncts or additives or anything like that, but actually the four base ingredients, which is water, malt, hops, and yeast. And in all honesty, all four ingredients are something that really, really changes the beer. Except hops actually. Yeah, you can dry hop, you can wet hop, you can use a hop back, you can use hop powder, you can use hop extract, you can do all this, you can throw it in at different types of points of the boil, but they don't seem to be as experimental as the other three ingredients. Water, you can use hard water, you can use soft water, you can use, each of those will do, well, you know what, I guess since water you really only have a few things you can do to it. It is kind of like hops in that you do have a limit to what you can do. And then malts, you have all these different malts. You can roast them, you can toast them, you can fucking burn them. You can do whatever you want with them, really. And they're an intriguing thing. Yeast is the most intriguing ingredient in beer. I mean, yeast can do so many different things to the beer. It changes the beer completely. Innocente they'd do the exact same beer and they'd ferment it at different temperatures. Even a 2-degree temperature changes the flavor of the beer immensely. And he used to be a yeast scientist, so this was the games he would play, you know, like, let's take this yeast and let's do it at 4 different temperatures and show you how different the beer is just from the yeast. The yeast will do different things to the malts. The yeast will do different things to other additives. The yeast won't eat through lactose, so if you that's how you make a milk stout. The yeast, Then there's other things you could use as well. You could say lactobacillus, you could say Brett, you could say anything like that. But, for me personally, I'm a malt guy. I'm a malt guy. My amber ale here. So malt is my thing, but I cannot deny that, all the ingredients are very important. What you do with them is very important. You can use a water that's going to add a lot of mineral content. You can use a water that's going to be salty. You can use a hard water. You can use a soft water. You can, again, use different yeast. You can use, there's hundreds of different strains of yeast, and there's yeast labs opening up everywhere. Escarpment Labs in Guelph is around doing, house yeast for people. So, There's a lot you can do with yeast. What's my first beer? My very first beer that I ever had a sip of, a drink of, was a old Vienna. Well, it was still an O'Keefe product, so I was like 5 or 6 at the time. My first beer that I really would get drunk on was Brador and Boomerang. I don't even know if Boomerang still exists. I was like 16 years old at the time. No, I my first Boomerang I drank, I was 16, but I was 18 when I first bought it. We went across the border into Hull, and me and my buddies walked into a corner store, a dépanneur, excuse me, and bought a 2-4 of, Boomerang, which was a lemonade-flavored lager. And we knew we were coming back to Ontario where it wasn't legal, so we also bought a whole shitload of chips, Doritos, and we opened every bag of Doritos, and then we ended up having like 12 bags of Doritos and putting like 2 bottles of Boomerang in each bag and coming back with it like that in case we got stopped on the bus. And then we drank it on the rugby field. Brador, Boomerang, and Old Vienna. That's why Old Vienna has a special place in my heart, even though I'm not a huge fan of the beer. Last and not least, who in the beer world do I look up to? I don't know if there's really many people at all in the beer world I look up to. I mean, it's beer. It's beer. And I think that's something that people don't seem to get, is it's just beer. Is there somebody in the beer world I really look up to? Not particularly. Going through my head, was there a brewer that started with nothing and got big and stuff? Most of the brewers I know had something that was able to give them money to get to where they were, or had friends or family that was able to help them out. I mean, I'm sure there are brewers that have come from nothing to something, but I mean, I can't really think of any. Michael Jackson, his writing did some amazing things. Garrett Oliver from Brooklyn Brewing. He has some awesome books that did some great things for beer too, and he's a great person to talk to. I don't know. I don't really know. I've met and made friends with a lot of great people doing this. I know that for Niche, she talks about BeerTube as this huge community and all that. It was a community at one point. It really was. It doesn't feel like a community anymore. There's too many people in it now that have very strong feelings against this or against that, or screw you for this or screw you for that, or I don't like you because of this, I don't like you because of that, or the feeling that we should all just get along because we like beer. There's a lot of people that like beer that I don't like. There's a lot of people that like beer that don't like me. It's just the way it is. And I think the happy-go-lucky feel of community that some of the newer people, Niche included, have towards this has made me like it even less, because they don't know the history of a lot of these people, and they just go right up to them and are like, "Ooh, you're amazing." There are some people in this community that are pariahs or are many other different things out there, and it is what it is. But I've made some amazing friends, both reviewers, viewers, brewers, festival goers, authors. I love it for the people that I did get to meet. Most of the guys on BDU I'm good friends with now. Lee, Nick, Paul from PA Brew News. Paul's been up here a couple times. He's slept right over there. Actually, he was sleeping right up there, to be honest with you. And then Nick came and slept right there, and he was right here, and he was getting pissed off because Nick kept him awake with his loud snoring. Gee, Radar, sure, you might not understand Guy, but he's awesome too. So nobody's probably watched this far because we're 22 minutes in, but I'm supposed to tag some people. I would love to hear Guy's answers, even though I won't understand them. I'd love to hear Nick from Maxwell Stars Beer Reviews answers. You know what? I'd love to hear Chris Peters' answers. Who else could I tag that hasn't been tagged yet? Average Joe. He's not going to do it, but I'd love to hear his answers. Maybe he'll do an "I'm not going to do this, but I'm going to answer them anyway" video. Maybe he would. No, he's not going to do a video. He could do a video with just his fucking avatar on there so nobody sees him still. Even though he's been seen on camera many a time. Lastly, I guess a fifth person. Who would I tag? I think most people I know have been tagged or have done this now. Most people I interact with. Beerzerker. The artist formerly known as Beerzerker. If you still are doing videos and all that, I'd love to hear your answers to these questions too. So I'm supposed to copy and paste the questions down there. This is going up right from my cell phone, so it's not going to be done right now. Hopefully by the time it uploads, it's there. So yeah. Thank you for watching. If you watch this long, come out to the Albino Rhino Beer Festival on May 27, 2017 from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. at 209 Ridge Road North in Ridgeway, Ontario. 39 Ontario craft breweries, 12 food vendors, and all proceeds going to the Ronald McDonald House of Hamilton. $20 in advance, $25 at the door. You get your sample cup, your mini can sample cup, 3 drink tokens, and your entrance. Yeah, you can buy your tickets on Ticket Scene. You can buy your tickets at Brimstone Brewing Company, Cayman Kettle Beer Works, or Plan B Beer Works. So either online, in Ridgeway, in Font Hill, or in St. Catharines. Thank you guys for watching. Have a wonderful evening. I hope to all see you there, and bye-bye.